G'day guys, back again. I've got a crack of a little kit for you today. A little piece of history, the jumping buggy, the tiger. I'd say it's also known as the Tamir grasshopper, if I was to take a guess. We're very close to it. I can't remember what a jet hopper looked like. But anyway, I'm going to call it the grasshopper, just because it reminds me of the Tamir grasshopper. And as you can tell by the sides of the box, I mean, if you remember the old Tamir magazines, the catalogues from the 1980s, maybe, I'd say. This here reminds me of a picture directly taken straight out of the Tamir catalogue of the grasshopper. I think it was jumping. Possibly even this as well. Maybe not the wheel underneath bit. But how cool is this little kit? Made in Japan. And mine didn't come with a motor. As soon as I saw this, I just had to pick it up because the Tamir Grasshopper was the first proper RC car I ever had. My dad picked it up for me when I was probably around maybe 12, and I was so stoked. I was just absolutely pumped. We went into the hobby shop together, and I remember him picking it up for me, and I think I'd probably been hounding him about it for probably 6 months or even longer. And I think he just snapped one day, and God bless him. And he took me into the hobby shop, and I picked up the kit only of the grasshopper. And he had an old, I think Futaba, is it Futaba? The stick radio control, you know, transmitter from an old airplane he had. And it still works, still actually works today. I think that Futaba stick set must be, look, if I was to take a guess, I would say it would be close to possibly 45 years old, I would say, possibly longer than that, because my dad had it for a long time before I was even contemplating RC cars. So it would be at least it could even have been 50 years old, that thing, and it's still working today, which is absolutely unbelievable. And that's probably why I still buy Futaba stuff today, because I know it's expensive, but geez, you know, when you find a brand where something works, I just stick with it. Once I picked this kit up, and this was number 4, I mean, look at this, guys. If you're a Tamir nut or an RC person, or you just like little scale, if you just like scale models in general, I mean, I thought this one, the Tamir Grasshopper I'm going to call it, I thought that it looks fantastic. But then I looked at this one here, and if you know the Sand Scorcher or the Monster Beetle, or the, is it Monster or the Blitzer Beetle, or what was it called, the other one? There's a Sand Scorcher. There's a couple been released by Tamir, the sort of buggies. And this one looks extra cool because it's actually got the top off. It's almost like half a Jeep, half a Volkswagen. And you, I'm a sucker for Jeeps, guys. I absolutely love Jeep Wranglers or Renegades. Not the new Renegade that Jeep's got out now. That looks like a dog's breakfast, but the real Renegades that used to look like the Wranglers. Absolutely fantastic looking kit. So these look great too. Interesting enough, these are, I've got some of the drivers on different sides of them. One's on the left-hand side, one's on the right-hand side, so that's interesting. But anyway, guys, I thought I'd just show something different on my channel, and I thought you don't get much different from this 1/28 scale. Let's have a look at the instructions. And if you're an RC nut, you know, just in general, when you were young, you had remote control cars, probably half the population either had a grasshopper or a hornet. And if you didn't have one of those, unfortunately, or if you probably had a jet hopper, the one you'd be really embarrassed about. But anyway, but as soon as I picked this up and I looked at these even the decals here, I mean, this is just Tamir Grasshopper all the way through with these decals. I'm actually building one now, Tamir Grasshopper, and as soon as I saw this, I thought, come on. Even the lights, just everything about it, the little roll bars, absolutely fantastic looking little kit. And again, you can put a little motor in it, and put your little batteries in it. It gives you a little pinion gear for the motor, but I didn't get the motor in the kit. Look at this little tubing here, as if that's going to do anything, but for your little bumper bar there, to make it a bit like a little shocky thingy-me-jiggy. And again, on the box, it had a detailed figure, which I sort of laughed at, but we'll have a look at that. Look at the little fire extinguisher here. Little Wild Willy would be very impressed by that little fire extinguisher. And look at this. Who doesn't love a Jeep jumping in the air? So cool, guys. I don't know if I'm the only one that gets excited about this little kit, but I absolutely think it's a little cracker. So different. Great little scale, actually. For 1/28th scale, I thought it would be a lot smaller, but it's actually a pretty decent size. First up, that really impressed me is look at these little tyres. You actually get sort of rubber tyres in the kit. And for all the sort of RC freaks out there, I mean, you even have sort of printing on the tyres. At first, I thought it might say Sand Scorcher, or was it Sand Gripper or something? But this one says Sand Super. Sand Super on these two back tyres. And the front ones also have writing on them. But this one's got Dunlop. Dunlop. And there's a bit of serial number there, SP or something, 41, I think it is. And then it's 145/10, if I'm reading that right. You get some nice little grip on those. Now, they are a little bit similar to the front of the Grasshopper tyres, a little bit similar. Probably a little bit wider and flatter. And these definitely remind me of, not the Grasshopper tyres, because they had sort of like a sand paddle tyre. This sort of reminds me of probably more like the Hornet, really. These sort of tyres, the little spiky ones. But something that really surprised me in this kit is when there's a detailed figure. Well, I thought, yeah, right, detailed figure. But I'm serious that when you look at this figure for what sort of the cheap sort of kit this is, it's an absolute cracker of a figure. Like, there is quite a bit of facial detail on this guy. Hopefully it'll show up. But you also get his legs as well. And I've got a funny feeling that that's because that will probably for the Jeep kit. I'm wondering if that's the same part, because these sort of, I think, will be on the Jeep as well. This here will definitely be on the Jeep, the jerry can. Fire extinguisher can go on both. And your steering wheel here. But this little figure, it's very impressive. He's got his little harness on him, if you like. And I just keep on thinking. I think in this kit, by the instructions, he doesn't have his legs on him. They might fit on him, but in the instructions here, they're showing that you don't need the legs, which is a little bit of shame, but they might not fit on here. But I'm guessing that the bottom half of the legs is for the Jeep. So I might have to go searching for that Jeep, because I really want a full figure. Oh, guys, I'm funny that way. There's no full legs going in this kit by the looks of it. I might try and squeeze them in if I can. But if not, I might have to try and track down the Jeep kit, guys, because that's the kind of crazy chicken I am. Probably the crazy thing about this kit, and it's probably obviously saving money, but I guess this goes in this kit here and also in the Jeep kit because of the colour of this one. And then you've got the colour of that of the tiger. I'm going to call it the grasshopper, guys. Because you've got your yellow rims here. And then you've got your black rims here, so that's going to be a bit odd. I'm guessing either you're going to have to paint either one set or both, depending on what you want. I think the Grasshopper actually had white tyres, didn't it? Rims, guys. So I might end up painting this white and paint my very cool Grasshopper-looking body white as well. I think I've just got to, in memory of my father. I don't think I have a choice. Very cool. And you can't tell me that that doesn't look like a grasshopper. And you get a pretty basic seat in there. And a little bit of the engine. And also you get these little spotties here that go on the front. And hopefully it'll show up. It's a bit hard to read in the yellow, but they also have some writing on them as well. And then you've got your little chassis here. And even this surprised me when you flip it over. They've got a little bit of detail on that as well underneath. I mean, it's not fantastic, guys, but, you know, we're talking 1/28th scale here, so I'm not expecting miracles. But it's better than nothing. And then you get your axles. You've got your sort of gear on there, stuck on one or glued on one. And your front axle. And I think this is for your bumper bar or maybe your roll cage or something like that. We've got the decals here. I think the Grasshopper decals, what were they? Oh, gosh, guys, off the top of my head. I think they were green and... was it red? Green and red? Oh, I can't remember. I should know, but I can't. Or was it green and black? Anyway, number 54. And you get a little, the tiger decal on the back. And there she is all laid out, guys. And I've got to say that I don't even think I've ever seen one of these in a hobby show that I've been to, or hobby expo, or hobby competition, or whatever you want to call it. I don't think I've ever seen one of these in there, because I'm pretty sure I would have spotted it, because I absolutely love this little set. Hopefully it goes together all right. As it stands right now, just looking at it, I can't rate it high enough. The only odd bit is like I said, the different colours in the rims. But other than that, just on face value, I think it's an absolute cracker of a little kit. Totally really impressed by that driver figure. Absolutely fantastic. The Jumping Buggy, the Tiger, 128 scale. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll catch you later.